Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory be to God forever in the name of Jesus. Thank you, fellow believers, for tuning in today. God love you, God bless you. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I say shalom to everyone in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God forever. I have some encouraging message to bring to you today. It is about the gospel of peace. Amen. That is the only gospel that's threatening. I know the devil does not want us, the evangelists and the teachers or the pastors or the missionaries to talk about the good news, what happened on the cross of Calvary, our new life now in Christ Jesus. I want to talk today about the new life which we have in Christ Jesus. As new creation people, as a new creation, you have a new life, and this life is an internal life. It has already begun, it has already started. So maybe you don't know, you can be passing through a kind of tribulation and attack and serious problems and things happening. You'll be like, oh my God, maybe you are not safe. If you have received the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, if you are a born again Christian, if you have already been baptized in the water, then you are a new creation, because the Bible says if anyone be in Christ and is a new creation, all things have passed away and everything has become new. You are a new being, new supernatural being. Your old man died, the old man called Mr. Flesh, the sinful nature. That old nature died on the cross. It was terminated on the cross of Calvary. And now you have a new life because you are quickening back. Because of the sin of Adam in the garden, when Adam and the wife, they cause a treason and they sin, the old man, the man who was the real Adam, which God created in his own image, died. That man died. The Bible says the wages of sin is death, because sin is a transgression of the law. So as they transgress against God's law, the command that God gave them in the garden, not to touch or to eat, not to eat of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, they did eat it. And they said that the devil beguiled them to do that, because the devil hates man, because man is created in God's image. And he beguiled them to eat of the fruit. So from that time, as they disobeyed God's law, they fell, they became the old nature, which was like a devil nature. That nature is a rebellion nature. That nature always rebel against God. You know, that nature came into them. So the nature of God that was in them left, that glory, you can say, because God is life and light. So that life light left. So the old nature, which is darkness and rebellious nature, they call it in the Bible, in the new covenant, the letters, the old man, you can call him Mr. Flesh. When you are born here on earth, everybody have that nature. You are automatically, you have that nature if you are born from Adam, because there is two Adam. There is the first Adam and there is the second Adam. So if you are born of the first Adam, that means you are now like the human race, the human nature here on earth, like all the sons of men. You still have the old nature until you become a born again Christian. That means you are born now of the Spirit of God. That means born now of the second Adam. Then you will be in Christ. You are born again of the Spirit of God. So now you have now a new life. Amen. So that is why they say now then the old man has passed away. The old man died. And then the new man start a new life, which is Jesus Christ. Christ is in you, is the hope of glory. So that new life comes start to live in you now. So you have a new nature. They call it the new creation. Oh, the new creation man. I always call it the new creation man. And this new creation man is not a Yoruba man. It's not an African man. It's not a Philippine man. It is the man from heaven, Jesus Christ the Lord, who come now to come and make his life in you if you become a born again Christian. So that old nature died. The Bible says that in Galatians 2:20. It says we are crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I am crucified with Christ. That I there is the old man, the old sinful nature. is crucified with Christ on the cross. When Jesus Christ died, we have a union with him. Everything is done together with him. This is a mystery, but it is written in the all in the letters that Paul wrote in the new covenant. If you read Colossians, Ephesians, Galatians, all those epistles explained there, especially Romans 6. So the old nature, when you become a born-again Christian, everything is in union with the Lord Jesus Christ. So we are crucified with Christ. So that old nature is crucified on the cross when Jesus Christ died. That old nature also is terminated on the cross, that Mr. Flesh. And then now, it is not the old nature is not living again. Is the new man now living in you? So that is why that Galatians 2:20 is one of my 9 best scriptures. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, it's not I, the old man, living here anymore. It is Christ that is living his life now in me. Christ is in me, is the hope of glory. That's what the Bible says. Colossians 1:27. Christ living his life now in me is the hope of glory. So when you become a new creation man, automatically you have a new life. A new life. And that life is an internal life. The life has already begun. It already begun. Because the wages of sin is death. That is what the Bible says in Romans 6:23. And the gift of God is eternal life. So when you become now a newborn again Christian, you receive a gift of righteousness, which is called, it's written in the book of Romans. So you receive that gift. You don't work for it because you are saved by grace through faith. So you receive that gift of eternal life. And that gift is already, has already begun. It has already begun in you. So you have this new life now. This life has already started. You have internal life. So the new creation man or a born again Christian does not die. I know it sounds weird, but that is the truth. You never die. Your body is not you. This body will turn back to the dust because God created man from the dust. He made mold man, the first Adam, from the dust and breathed a life light, his own essence in man, and man become a living soul. So now, when you are a new creation, you have received you died with Jesus Christ in baptism, and you are raised again to this new life again. And this new life has already begun. You never die, so you have internal life already living in you. This Holy Spirit that you have received, the Bible says, don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? This Holy Spirit living in your spirit now is that internal life. He's the one that gives you life. The Bible says that, say the flesh profit nothing. That in the book of John 6:63, but the word I speak unto you, they are life. So now you have internal life. This internal life has already begun here on earth. The flesh will die, turn to dust, or you can call it this tent, or you can call it the temple, or you can call it the house, because it's just a house, because you are made in 3 different parts. That part, you are a spirit being the same like God. That's why we are created in God's image. Nobody have seen you. Nobody have ever seen God. They have seen Jesus because he is the image of the invisible God. And nobody have ever seen you. They have seen your body. If you die, it's also the body they will see, but they never see you. So now you are made in God's image. You are a spirit being. And then you are a supernatural spirit being. You have a soul, which is your intellect, your will, and your emotion. And then you live in a body. So this body will die. Your soul will never die. Your spirit will never die, but this flesh will turn back to dust. Amen? In the name of Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ now came and died on, the sin was judged on the flesh of Jesus Christ so that we can receive now eternal life. When Jesus died on the cross, he died for the sin of the whole human race. And now when you believe in the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will receive a free gift of righteousness. So now you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So what I wrote here, let me go to the other side. Glory be to God forever in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The new life we have in Christ Jesus. Born again Christians, new creation man. Their life is unlimited. We have unlimited life, so we have eternal life. And with the new creation man, nothing is impossible, because we are translated now from the kingdom of darkness. We come now to the God's marvelous kingdom of light. And God is life, because that's why they say that John 10:10, the thief come to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus came to give us life, in eternal life. Jesus himself said that I am the way, the truth, and the life. So this eternal life we receive through Jesus Christ, his sacrifice on the cross of Calvary. Amen. In the name of Jesus. So we are now new creation. We walk by now by faith and not by sight. Amen. All the promises of God are in Jesus Christ, and it's yes and amen. So now the old man was terminated at the cross. The old man died at the cross. We are married now to a new man, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Satan does not like this topic, because he was defeated on the cross of Calvary. Every time you speak about the cross and you speak about the new creation man, you are pointing on the defeat of the of Satan, because the Satan likes to operate in that old man, which is the man we like to fear. But at the cross, the Bible says in the book of Romans 6:7, say at the cross, that old man, that Mr. Flesh, was crucified. He was nailed on the cross. And when he was nailed, all his deeds and his action and all his work was crucified also on the cross. Amen. So then you have now a new life. All his affection, his lust, everything was crucified on the cross. So now we have a new one. The devil was defeated on that very cross. So if you believe in the gospel today, I just want to make a short video to tell you that if you are a new creation, if you are in Christ, you are a new creation. All things have passed away. The old man has passed away. The old man died. Amen. In the name of Jesus, you also died with the Lord Jesus. Everything in union with Jesus. Your life is hidden now in Christ, and Christ is in God. Amen. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. So now, when Christ, who is your life, because now you have a new life, when Christ, who is your life, shall appear, Colossians 3 says, you shall appear with him. So now you are now on earth here. You are a supernatural being. You have eternal life. You will never die again. Your life has begun immediately the day you receive the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. So now the old man, or the disobedient man, that old man who was a sinful man, died on the cross. The book of Ephesians 2 says that now you are quickened. You know, Ephesians say you are quickened now. The old man is quickened to life. So your spirit is quickened now to life. So you have now eternal life. You have started eternal life here on earth already till forever. Now Jesus is living in you. You are the workmanship of Christ. You are working with him one-to-one as partners. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, to save soul, to do the work of God and all that. Your life has already begun. You belong now to the kingdom of God. You are a heavenly citizen. Your citizenship is in heaven. You are the body of Christ, the family of God. Amen. If you be in Christ, the Bible says that you are Abraham's seed, and then you are joined here according to the same promise. So now you belong to God's family. You are heir of salvation, the Bible says. Amen. In Jesus' name. So you are heir of salvation. Now you are just here on earth, just passing your time as an ambassador here on earth, as God's representative here on earth, to finish the work that Jesus Christ has to work before he come and take the church together. So your life has already begun. You will never die again. Your body will turn back to dust. But you yourself, your spirit and your soul have received, has been quickening, have life, and will live forever in the name of Jesus. I hope this you understand, and I hope that this encourage you in the mighty name of Jesus. I like to talk about the new creation man. I have a special revelation about this new creation man that God gave me for many, many years, that that when that we all on earth, we are all, we have the old nature, and when we are born again, we have now a new nature, this new creation man. You become a new creation. And the Bible says, even in the book of Ephesians, if you read the whole Bible, it keep telling you, especially in the letters, it says put off the old man and put on the new man. Say put off the old man he did, because the old man died. Amen. Because you are now, the old man passed away, and now you are a new creation man. So you put on the new man, which is with his old nature, which is in true in holiness and in righteousness. Amen. Glory be to God. And that if you're a new creation man, you will be producing the fruit of the Spirit. The old man has passed away. Mr. Flesh has passed away. So the works of the flesh has no power over you. The Bible says sin cannot have dominion over you, because you are not under the law, but you are under God's grace. Amen. Glory be to God. I hope this encouraged you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you have not given your life to Jesus, I'm a missionary, a teaching evangelist. My name is Sister Evangelist Attell. If you need some of these cards, you can ask them. I can send them to you. You can write them below. It says Jesus loves you in different languages, in many, about 20 languages, and I can send them to you to share the gospel. Also, as a missionary, we put them on cars, on people's street. That is what I do. Amen. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. Give your life to Jesus. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. Ask the Lord Jesus and say, forgive me of my sin. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, wash me with your blood. Make me a new creation in the name of Jesus. Amen. And God will write. And then you find a good somebody who can baptize you in the water. That means your old nature is dying with Jesus. And then you are resurrected into a new life. That is what baptism means. It's a funeral service, that the old man, that old man, Mr. Flesh, is dying with the Lord Jesus Christ. And then you are now resurrected, like how Jesus was resurrected, into a new life. So you are starting the new life now. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And then you can get a new covenant Bible and start to read the letters, so that you can renew your mind as a new creation man. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. I thank Jesus for his word. I hope that he gives you wisdom, revelation, and knowledge in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that you are now in Christ. Amen. The second Adam. You have been translated from the first Adam to the second Adam. Amen. From the kingdom of darkness to God's marvelous kingdom of light. From death to life. If you have Jesus Christ, you have life. If you don't have Jesus Christ, you don't have life. I mean internal life. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I hope this encouraged you. God bless you. You can subscribe down below. You can leave your comment, a prayer request, anything that you want to know. And God bless you. Thank you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. I'll see you in the next audio or in the next video in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Glory be to God. Amen.